Joining us today for his take on the markets, Joey Roxas of Eagle Equities. Hi, Joey. Good morning.
Good morning, Mimi.
Okay, so just wanted to share the PSEI actually opening slightly higher, up by less than a tenth of 1%, 4.6201. So I guess when you look at the big picture, Joey, you've got increasing inflation, triggering bouts of volatility, and the resurgence of virus in Asia. Asia Pacific daily cases at the highest since the start of the pandemic, and not even including India yet. Where do you think is the safe place to park your cash today?
I think you should, just looking at the components of our index, okay? Q1 figures are already out, and they're pretty good. Out of the 30 stocks in the index, 19 of the 30, Q1 2021 is higher than Q1 2020. If you extend that for the whole year, very simple times four, okay? You will have 26 out of 30 companies, or 86%, making more than they did last year.
Uh-huh.
There are 13 of those companies that are at single-digit PE ratios today, or yesterday's close. And there are so many that are still below their January 2020 levels, BC, before COVID.
Uh-huh.
Three, to reach that level, go back to that level, you can make around more than 58%, more than 50%, and two, more than 40%. I think the markets, the components of the index are already undervalued. So, mm-hmm. for institutions, for people who are more in the market for the longer term, you should already start buying. If it goes down, better.
But when they go down, how long should we expect for them to stay down before we can actually make the yield?
At least for the Philippines, with the loosening of ECQ and whatever else they call it, the economy should start picking up again. Their vaccinations have started. You have like 40, according to Galvez, it's like 40 million shots coming in. That should be a lot of it. That should be enough, at least for NCR. Maybe it won't cover all the outlying barangays and municipalities, but the main bulk in NCR should be okay.
Okay. Joey, let's briefly go over some interesting corporate stories that we had from late yesterday and this morning. Pilipinas Shell is selling. Finally, it's been finalized. 45% of Malampaya, their whole 45% stake in Malampaya, to Dennis Oy of Davao for $380 million. What do you make of this deal? I'm sure Shell has a reason for, you know, unloading this asset. But what do you think Dennis Oy sees in Malampaya that Shell apparently is no longer seeing?
I think the reason that Shell gave is really that they just want to realign their businesses.
Uh-huh.
So we just have to take it at that. No? The Shell sale was at $380 million.
Uh-huh.
If I remember right, Chevron's 45%, which Dennis Uy also bought, was $575 million. So the difference of about $100 million, because the Shell sale includes an $80 million additional additional
payment up
if commodity prices remain good, etc., etc.
Uh-huh.
So that's 480 from last year, 575. So I assume that these companies are computing their selling price based on a discounted cash flow, etc., etc. Mm-hmm. So that means that 575, they probably already made Udena, probably already made that 100 million in this year.
Mm-hmm.
You have about 4 or 5 years left for until 2024, and that should all be probably all paid up within that time. So it's all a discounted cash flow figure. Mm-hmm. You're hoping first that the oil price or gas prices move higher from here so that you can make your money back faster.
Mm-hmm.
Now, there's always also the hope that it will be extended.
Yeah.
Remember,
the life will be extended.
It's expiring 2024. If you extend that a little, even a year more, you have like $200 million more dollars coming in.
Okay, interesting math there. Joey, I just wanted to share Pilipinas Shell share prices right now joining the broader market down by a quarter of 1%, 20 pesos, 60 centavos a piece. Here's another interesting Pilipinas story.
Shell, the listed company is not the owner of Malampaya.
But they're part of the same group.
Yes.
They're part of the same group. Different unit.
It should not affect Pilipinas Shell, the listed company.
Okay. Joey, here's another interesting story. There was a PhilStar report yesterday that cited a source that said Mondanisin's $1.2 billion IPO has attracted 11 cornerstone investors. The IPO has been reset for June 1st. What do you make of this? I mean, when you've got 11 cornerstone investors, they cornered, I think, $700 million out of the $1.2 billion IPO. Is that a good sign? Is that a boost for confidence?
Well, I think that's a good sign. Actually, at the new 1350 IPO price, it's priced more or less equivalent to its peers that are already listed. So not bad. It's just the only real problem there is that the size, no? For local investors, the size is not really appealing because, you know, the bigger you are, the harder it is to move, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So this one, I think it's good for the long term. Because of its size, it might be included in the index one day. Of course, there's a seasoning period, maybe 6 months or a year or something like that. But mm-hmm. because of its sheer size, it could be included. The other thing is that hopefully, if or the foreign demand for the IPO spills over into the post-listing transactions.
Okay. Joey, just here's one more interesting story. According to the Department of Budget and Management, government infrastructure spending jumped 25% in the first quarter to $195.2 billion. Do you think it's time for the infra plays to once again go on a rally?
They should spend even more and take up the slack on spending that was given up by the private sector because of the pandemic. So government really has to kickstart the spending, and one way to do it is by infrastructure.
And these would be good for cement plays, the conglomerates who are into infra?
Cement, construction, yes.
Okay. Joey, here's an interesting foreign story that we got yesterday. Okay, here's an interesting foreign story that we got from yesterday, a mystery box craze in China, where you buy a small box with an unknown present or gift inside, usually a collectible figurine. In December, a mystery box pop maker actually raised some $700 million in an IPO. The industry is estimated to be worth $4.7 billion by 2024. But there is supposedly a dark side. Sometimes what you find inside the boxes are not figurines or collectibles, but live pets, puppies and kittens, many of whom actually die in transit. Do you have any thoughts on this sort of a trend, the mystery box trend happening in China, and whether you think that can catch on here in Manila?
I'm not sure. this brings to mind, you remember Forrest Gump?
Yeah.
Life is like a box of chocolates.
Box of chocolate. You never know
you
what
never
you're going to get.
What you're gonna get. And also, there's, well, at least I know my son loved his Kinder Joy Kinder eggs, which you buy at any Mercury or any of the toy stores. There's this little egg with a chocolate little egg with a little surprise inside. So I guess these are just the bigger versions. You know, the mystery box is just a bigger version of these things. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I guess it could pick up. Locals will probably look at it like a raffle. You might get more for what you actually pay. I think Lazada has some mystery box.
Mystery boxes. Offering. Okay. Finally, Joey, we've come to the most exciting part of the conversation, the blind item. Talk to us about the stock that you're monitoring closely. Don't tell us, just describe. So what do you have for us this morning?
This company is in one of the sectors we mentioned earlier that can benefit from infrastructure spending. It is part of the index. It is below its January 2020 BC level, actually around 24%. You have about 24% to go. It recently, in spite of not a very good year last year, it recently gave a dividend equivalent to the previous year.
Oh.
And if they continue to give that every year, you will end up with a yield based on the current price of around 8.8%.
Wow.
Now, if that you equate that, instead of getting a rate which will yield you 4 or 5%, and you bring up the price to equate the two yields, right? Then you can possibly still double the price and you'll still make over 4%.
Okay. Okay, we're just going to have to guess which stock this is. Joey, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Have a great weekend.
Thank you, Mimi.